Hello friends, welcome to lesson 19 on batch scripting. In this lesson we will talk about operators, and before starting, if you guys haven't checked my previous video on batch scripting, I would highly recommend you guys to go and check that out. The link will be in the description. So let's start with operators. An operator is a symbol that tells the computer to perform some specific mathematical or logical manipulations. In batch script, the following types of operators are possible. They are arithmetic, relational, logical, assignment, and bitwise. So let's start with arithmetic operators. Batch script supports the normal arithmetic operation as any other language will do. So these are addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and modulus. So let me show you one example with arithmetic operators. So at the rate, echo off to stop the echoing, pause to hold the screen, REM for remark, and let's say arithmetic operations. Okay, so once that's done, let's create a variable here. Here I'm using numeric type of variable, so slash a equal to 5, set slash a b equal to 10, and let's assign it to c slash a c equal to 10 plus 5. Let's say variable a is equal to variable b. Indirectly we are writing 10 plus 5, so let's print that echo c. So here what we are doing in variable c, we are assigning variable a addition of variable b, and the addition here is the arithmetic operator. So the output of this should be 15. So before doing that, just save the file, create a bat executable file, filler.bat, save that. So let's check the output of this file. It should be 15, and let's check that. Yeah, the output is 15. So that was about the arithmetic operators. So let's move to the next one, relation operators. Relation operators allow the comparison of two objects. So here we have EQU, that stands for equality. It will test the equality between two objects. We have NEQ, that will test the difference between two objects. LSS stand for less than, LEQ stand for less than equal to, GTR for greater than, and GEQ for greater than and equal to. So let me show you an example with this also, relation operator. So let's modify this one, and let's say if variable a is not equal to the value in the variable v, then print, let's say it's working. So here if you see, the value of variable a is 5, it's not equal to value of variable b, so that's the condition is true. So this if condition is satisfied, it will come inside and it will print this. So it should print it's working at the output window. So let's check that. Here you can see it's printing, it's working. So that was about the relation operators. So let's move to the next one, that says logical operators. So these are used to evaluate Boolean expression basically. The batch language, or you can say the batch language, is equipped with a full set of Boolean logical operators like AND, OR, XOR. But these are only used for binary numbers. So we have AND, OR, XOR. So let's move to the next one, that says assignment operators. Batch script language also provide assignment operators. So they are, let me show you, addition and equal to, subtraction and equal to, multiplication and equal to, division and equal to, and modulus and equal to. So all these are supported by assignment operators. So let me show you one example with that also. Let's modify this one. Let's say a equal to plus equal to 10. So and let's print that. Okay, so let's print that echo percent a. So here what we are doing, first we are assigning value 5 to the variable a, then what we are doing, we are adding value 10 in the value of variable a, that's 5. So 10 plus 5, 15. So it should print 15 at the output. So let's check that. You can say 15 has been printed at the output. So that was about the assignment operators. So let's go on the next one, bitwise operator. Bitwise operator are also possible in batch script. So here we have AND. This is a bitwise AND operator. This is a bitwise OR operator. And the last one, caret. This is a bitwise XOR operator. So you can also use this bitwise operator in your program. So that was all for this video. I hope you guys have enjoyed the video. In the next video, we will learn about functions in batch script. Till then, stay tuned, stay connected, and thanks for watching the video, guys.